So dear old Maslow, which I'm sure you've learned to be critical about, I think it kind of works, but not as a hardwired thing, but certainly as a cultural thing in America. You can't tell back lies unless you've got a full stomach, whereas if you're a Zen Buddhist, you just need a handful of rice today and not sure where they'll come tomorrow, and you can sell back to life. I mean, that's about the conditions that you need for meaningfulness. But it's where this fits into my argument, is that if we can only self-actualize on the American model, then we're still going to, in ecological terms, consume a lot of resources. If we can be more Zen-like, we can do that without walking so heavily on the earth in the kind of ecological sense. Now, developing countries, the BRIC countries, I guess, and particularly the more eastern ones, you might think are closer to their spiritual roots, which are different from ours. Some of them are Muslim. You will notice that the Arab banks didn't get caught by the credit crunch because they have different principles around taking interest, except in this country, as I think you're right, is the co-op bank, which was unscathed because they have different principles, but nonetheless, ones that keep them out of trouble. You know the bank, thank you, John, again. That's true. So there's a lot to play for, and whether we can have the kind of leadership encouragement, whether we can learn as much from the developing countries in terms of that. And I think this is in the balance, and this is implications for individuals or Christians in the States. And is there a new role for leadership? and we just heard that Rolls Royce, China's taken over the biggest cars for Rolls Royce. If I showed you that without giving you any clues and asked you where it was, where you said it was, is Los Angeles. Yeah, it's China. And I'm told it's 8 or 9 or 12 lanes wide, and I gather it's 15 or 20 miles long. So if they all do that, we're heading for trouble. And I'm told there's more tarmac now in China than there is square miles in the UK, and I think by several times. This is a big place. There we have it. So if it's not too late, and it depends on whether you believe in tipping points and all that stuff, which is hard, if we're beyond the tipping point already, we're done for, as I think Lawson believes. So don't bother with the ego stuff, his argument. But we might, with the right kind of leadership, which, with the right kind of leadership, which combines the scientific and the human relations, we might be able to steer our way through this one. End of story. Thoughts, comments? Agree, disagree? Implications for leadership development?